40-foot triple, so it is the largest boat that operates this section. The 40 feet length is three engines. We've got three Cummins Marine, three diesels, and each engine powers its own Hamilton pump. And so all our power is going out, is transferring from those engines to those pumps out the back of the boat. Water's sucking up underneath and going out the back of the nozzle with a really highly pressurized stream. So nothing hanging below the bottom of the boat.
Boat locks, and also has fish passes, has ladders on it.
where fish get trapped and then transported to hatcheries in Idaho and Oregon, and also one in Washington. So that's where our salmon and steelhead go, where they get trapped and get sent to hatcheries where they're reared in a controlled environment. So that's mainly what we get, is a hatchery run of salmon, of Chinook salmon, and steelhead trout. So our spring run goes, it actually goes, the spring run of Chinook goes right away into the summer. It's over, pretty much. The season ended in July, officially closed. And now we're just waiting for our fall run of Chinook to begin, which will open up August 28th. And then after that, there'll do leave this area. If you guys have been down here early this morning, you would have seen, when it was cooler, you would have seen all the raptors. They all put in early in the morning when it's much more cooler, because they usually have a lot of gear to pack on the boat, a lot of stuff from home, so it's a fair amount of work that goes into it. But this is the launch for them, and this is the end of the road also. So when they leave here, set off, their next takeout opportunity to get rigged around to where they can meet them on the other side is 32 miles downstream. So, mostly a multi-day river. About 3 days is kind of the minimum that people will spend down here. Unless you have a jet boat to bring you back up, which we do bring a fair amount of rafting groups back up river. side is, all of our extended pieces are kind of disappearing. Yeah. Officer, for the rate permitted, health officer for spots like this, even this small where it was just like maybe a couple acres, would put a health officer in. But anything that they harvested as far as fruit and vegetables was concerned, in their yards, through the orchards, was all, that was all canned. Canned supplies were a big supply that they brought to right now. Also, it makes this not the fruits and vegetables. I mean, any kind of meat, fish, sturgeon meat, big meat, any mildeer or elk, anything like that that's been harvested, a lot of that stuff is canned. Give it a longer shelf life. And it didn't really take much as far as like a root cellar, something dug down and put a little bit cooler to. went about 6 feet.